Good.
Right. Good, Alice. Far away. Put your hands up. Gareth.
So, no, I'm just putting my
hand
up. Oh, no, come on, Gareth.
We know you want to start, really.
So were you satisfied with that tonight, David?
I was very satisfied. Fighting a guy I didn't really know too much about. There's not really much online about him. I heard he was decent in sparring against a few people here and there, but obviously it's rumours. So I just needed to focus on landing quick, clean shots and do the things I've been doing in training. I'm glad I got in the ring with someone who was taller than me. You know, let me practice my right hand. There's all the current champions are bigger than I am. So, you know, punching upwards is something that I've been working on in training, and it really worked really well. The first right hand that nailed him was a really big shot, and I was very surprised he got up from it. Very, very surprised. Most people would be sleeping for a good few minutes, but he got up, to his credit, and you know, he got clumped a few more times. But you know, I was very, very happy with my performance. In the first round, I missed a few punches here and there, tried to get him out of there a little too much, a bit rushed my work a little bit. But when there wasn't much coming back at me, so I felt comfortable to do that. But against a higher caliber of opposition, I'd have to be a little bit more defensive with my attacks and not be so sort of blasé with just letting my hands go like I did with this guy.
Were you worried when you went down on that jab that it was going to have an almost disappointing finish?
No, because the jab was a really, it was a quick shock that I felt his jaw open. I hit him with a jab. People assume, because people think a jab is not a knockout punch. But my jabs, believe it or not, I've been told by pretty much everyone I've jabbed, but they say it's like a right hand. He wasn't expecting it, and it was a short, crisp shot, and I felt it go right through my arm, so I know it was a hard shot. And that jab would have put a lot of people down if it hit clean on the chin. And I'm just happy that, you know, the crowd seemed happy. It was a lovely atmosphere. The text I got through said everyone watching on Dave at home. Really enjoyed it. It was a good night's entertainment, and it was free. Everybody got the opportunity to watch it, which is nice to, you know, show, you know, big time boxing to the masses. And, you know, I'm just really happy to be doing my part with with this exciting British heavyweight scene at the moment. It's as good as I think it's ever been, and I'm just really happy to be part of it now.
David, Jose Mourinho was in the crowd. Did you speak to him before?
I didn't get a chance to see him. I'm trying to catch things at the after party, so I'm going to probably catch up with him there. But he's a big boxing fan. I saw him at the Joshua fight a couple of months back, and he's a big fight fan, and I think he came out of his family today. So it's nice to see, you know, big names, important people there at ringside enjoying boxing. As it was a lovely crowd as well. I had a look around. Good looking crowd. I was like with the Oscars or something. Looking around, like, okay. But yeah, it's nice to see a different look, a different crowd. Hopefully that was conveyed on television as well as ringside. The music, you know, everyone was telling me they loved the music. They loved, like, it was a different atmosphere than what you get with your typical boxing match. And that's really what I wanted to bring with sort of the heyday campaign.
You had two wins now on after 3.5 years out.
Yeah.
Is Briggs really a big enough challenge for you next time out, or should
I hope
be
so.
Stepping up on
I hope that? I hope Shannon Briggs is a big enough task. He makes big enough noise. He's ranked higher than I am. He's he's on a winning streak. I'm not sure how he looked tonight. He looked quite explosive. I'm not sure what the caliber of the guy was who Dimitrenko pulled out, so he got someone in last minute. He does what he normally does, throws big shots, but I don't believe I'll get hit by his punches. But it'd be a big fight, it'd be a huge fight. And, you know, walking down the street, more people actually saying to me, you know, fight Shannon Briggs, because he's in the press, he's in the papers, he's going to fight, screaming and shouting. And all of the world champions, all of the big names, as you say, are busy. You know, they've got big fights coming up, and myself and Shannon, we don't. You know, so I think we should fight each other, and then the winner of that then starts looking at world titles. Hopefully by the time myself and Shannon Briggs fight, you know, the heavyweight landscape, we will know who would have won out of Tyson Fury and Klitschko. Deontay Wilder, we'll know what happens with that situation with Povetkin. And Joshua would have beaten, I believe, Brazil, and probably looking at having another fight in November. You know, whether that's me, whether that's someone else, I don't know. But I can just focus on Shannon Briggs. That's a fight that the fans want to see, and I'm excited about that. I'm looking forward to it.
Would you be hopeful maybe December then?
Possibly. If the opportunity arises, I'd take it with both hands. You know, I'm in boxing for the big fights, and at the moment, other than the champions, other than fighting for the heavyweight championship of the world, I can't think of a bigger fight than myself and Shannon Briggs.